Hey guys, Dr. Berg here. Listen, in this video, I want to discuss how to dissolve kidney stones. But I want to make a disclaimer first. Make sure that you're discussing this information, any changes with your doctor, because this is not meant for replacement for any meds or any surgery that they're going to do on you, okay? So I just wanted to present this as extra information to work with he or she in helping to, you know, prevent this from coming back or helping slow down stones. Sometimes it takes several months to dissolve stones. And if you can prevent an invasive procedure, I think it's worth it to try this. You can always go back and get an ultrasound and see if the stones are shrinking. But here's the data. Most kidney stones are calcium oxalate stones or calcium phosphate stones. 20% or a little less than 20% of the stones are uric acid crystal stones. Okay, so there's two different, there's several, but these are the main two. Now, gallstones are completely different than kidney stones as far as the formation. Gallstones are more cholesterol stones because of lack of bile. Kidney stones, if we're going to talk about the most common, are calcium oxalate stones. Okay? So there's really two things that you need to put your attention on. One is removing the oxalates from your diet. This is like a waste product from metabolism, but oxalates bind with calcium in the kidney. Okay, and they develop these little crystals that then can create a lot of problems. They can get lodged right out of the kidney, right before the ureter, and cause a backup of fluid and pressure and cause a lot of pain. The symptoms from kidney stones are very similar to the symptoms from gallstones. So sometimes you don't know what is causing what because they're very, very similar, but you can get an ultrasound or a CAT scan to find that out. All right, so the underlying mechanism is that usually the person is low in citrates and high in oxalates. Now, citrates actually help prevent the formation of stones and help dissolve stones. So the two mechanisms that you want to focus on are increasing citrates in the diet, decreasing oxalates. All right? So let's go through step one. Number one, you want to increase citrates. There are many types of lemon juice that you can consume. I like the volcano lemon juice. You can even get lemon juice, any lemon juice, and it will work, but I would like to recommend that you get a higher quality lemon juice because it's a lot more nutritious. Volcano is the best, but you can just get organic lemon juice. But lemon juice has a lot of citrates. Any mineral with citrate at the end of it is a citrate. So you can do potassium citrate, which I like that one way better than sodium citrate. But potassium citrate will break off, so a good portion of the potassium will go this way, the citrate will go that way, and it starts to form with the calcium and help break up the stones. So that will handle the citrate. Number two, you want to avoid oxalates. Now, I put a link down below of all the different categories of foods and what has high, extremely high oxalates and what are very low, and you can use that. But spinach is at the top of the list. Spinach has hundreds of milligrams of oxalates per ounces of spinach. And then we also have avocado is high. Dates are high. Grapefruit is high. Potato, wheat, beans, beets are very high. Swiss chard is very high. Kiwi, canned pineapple is very high. Figs and tofu are very high in oxalates. Okay. Nuts, unfortunately, are very high. Almonds are very, very high. I'm sorry. Did you realize that kale is very low in oxalates, even though it's a cruciferous? It has like 17 milligrams per 3 ounces. Spinach is hundreds, okay? Cabbage is low in oxalates. Bok choy is low. Cauliflower is low. Cucumber is low. So take the list down below, dissect it, make notes on what you're going to do as far as you're changing your diet. Now, the point I want to make is this. It is true in some of the other videos I talked about calcium coming out of solution into the different soft tissues when your body is too alkaline, okay? So when you have alkalosis, calcium participates or precipitates out of the solution and starts clogging up joints and things. That's true, but if you take dietary calcium, like some cheese and things like that, that will not end up in the calcium through the kidneys. In fact, some of that calcium through the digestive system will bind with the oxalates and lower the chance of getting a stone. The thing you need to worry about is taking dietary extra calcium, like supplements, like calcium in a supplement form, especially calcium carbonate. You want to avoid that. So just make sure you're not taking any supplements with calcium, but you can take some dietary foods that are higher in calcium, okay? The other point I want to make is there's a confusion with vitamin D. There's mixed reviews. A lot of the recent research says that vitamin D actually helps lower stones. Some of the older research says it will increase it, but here's my viewpoint. Vitamin D helps the absorption of calcium in the intestines by 20 times. That doesn't necessarily mean it ends up in the kidney, okay? So I think it's okay. Vitamin K2 is another vitamin that's very important if you have kidney stones, because that helps you hold calcium in the bone. That helps you remove calcium from soft tissues and puts it in the bone where it should be. So this is a very good anti-kidney stone vitamin. There's also mixed reviews in vitamin C, or ascorbic acid, you know, synthetic, like large amounts of ascorbic acid. Some studies show that it increases, some studies do not. So I don't have an opinion of vitamin C. I don't know exactly what it does. Some people think that cranberry helps dissolve kidney stones. It does not. All cranberry will do will help lessen the stickiness of the bacteria on your bladder. Okay, now let's talk about uric acid crystals. Now, that particular type of stone usually comes when your pH is too acid, your urine pH is too acid, and that could happen after several things. Number one, you did a ketosis diet, and all of a sudden you end up with a kidney stone, or you have an insulin problem. A lot of diabetics have kidney stones because of the sugar involved, because sugar, fructose, that kind of can lead to uric acid building up in the body. So if you have more of the uric acid stones, what you want to do is increase the pH, and you can do that or alkalize the body a little bit more by taking the potassium citrate or even lemon juice, because both of these are alkaline. Even though the lemon juice is an acid, it turns into an alkaline ash in the body. So actually, these two remedies will be good for both of these. The last point I want to mention that's very, very important is that if you have a uric acid crystals in the kidney, they're little stones, or gout, you need to fix the insulin. You need to lower the insulin, okay, because it usually comes from insulin resistance. I'm going to put a link down below to give you the data. I just wanted a more of a comprehensive video, because I have a lot of different videos talking about different aspects, but this is a real comprehensive video just to give you the overview of what to do if you had a kidney stone. All right, thanks for watching.